e intorno a me girava il mondo come sempre. Girando, girando, spazio senza fine, con gli amori appena nati, con gli amori già finiti, con la gioia e col dolore della gente come me. Un mondo soltanto.
Well, boys, it is that time of the year. We have the first sniff of football. Thursday night football, Chiefs, Texans, and I am Commissioner Lewis welcoming you into another episode of Commissioner's Corner. The first really exciting one of the year. I'm going to go through each team's, each matchup this week's projections of all of our games, talk a little bit about you know, everybody's team, and really see where we're going with week one. Just want to start off by saying that I'm going to sit Kerryon Johnson week one as long as A.J. Brown continues to look like he's going to play. This is no indication of how I feel of him as a player. I still have full confidence in Kerryon Johnson, but it's just from a pure projected point standpoint in the flex. I don't want to take out anybody else, and he seems like a logical fit. So, no strike against Kerryon. I still think he's going to have a great year. He's going to be the RB1 for the Detroit Lions. I'd say 15 to 16 touchdowns this year, probably 2,000 yards. Something along those lines would be what I look at for his numbers. But let's go to the first game. We've got myself, Huey Lewis in the news versus Luke's Belly Rolls in a great matchup to begin. A lot of people are going to say that Chandler's team is going to win this game. I love that people are doubting my team. I love when my team's the underdog. That's when we perform our absolute best. Russell Wilson, bust. Chris Carson, bust. Jonathan Taylor, actual bust. Tyreek Hill, he's probably going to break his leg in the first game of the season. Will Fuller, injured last season. Guy sucks. Jared Cook, old. Devin Singletary, never heard of him. 49ers defense, I'll give you that one. And Will Lutz, Will with one L, is a piece of shit. So I'm going to scratch. I'm already looking forward to week two, actually. I'm going to beat Chandler. I'm looking forward to week two. Our next matchup, pardon my team, Ethan Moran versus Keeking It Real, Luke Cosiano. Pardon my team with a 52% win probability here, but that is not accounting for the fact that Keeks has not put in a defense or a kicker yet. Keeks is projected to have 79.3 points without either of those positions. Pardon my team, 95.8. So realistically, it should be a pretty close matchup. Kyler Murray versus Matt Ryan. Both those guys are pretty terrible. I give the running back edge to Keeks, Derrick Henry, and Kenyon Drake over Joe Mixon and Alvin Kamara every day. The rest of their teams are pretty similar. Let's see what Keeks does with the defense here. He doesn't have one on his roster, so we'll see where that goes. But my personal take is I think part of my team is going to blow Luke's team out of the water. I love the way Ethan's team is set up. Other than Matt Ryan, Joe Mixon, Cortland Sutton, Mike Gesicki, I like Robert Woods. Eagles defense is terrible, but they're playing Washington, so you got to give them that. All right, on to game three. We have Margo's Loin, the new arrival. Will Rouse claiming, oh, his team's the best in the world. Oh, my God, my team's going to kill everybody. I won my fantasy league back with my pussy friends from fucking Wheaton, Illinois. Who knows what the fuck that is? It's a piece of shit town. I don't even know where in Illinois, but it sucks. It's west of Chicago. It's a piece of shit town. I hated it. There were no gas stations open when I went there. All I could do was fuel up. I couldn't get anything to refresh myself. I just took a massive shit in Will's house, and I can't go anywhere. His town sucks. Your friends suck, Will, back from Wheaton. They don't know how to play fantasy football. They don't take it this seriously. So go fuck yourself. Your team's terrible. Christian McCaffrey, bust. I'd be surprised if Lamar Jackson puts up over 5 points against that Browns defense in week one. Todd Gurley hasn't played good since 2017. Juju Smith-Schuster is an average wide receiver at best. He's just lucky that he's there by necessity. AJ Green, I mean, he could have a great year. He could get turf toe and be out for 2 years again. Zach Ertz, sure, he's all right. Philadelphia, again, what do we know? Ronald Jones, the second, is my favorite player on this team. Steelers defense is good, but, you know, whatever. Justin Tucker as the kicker. And he is projected 103.8 points, a whopping 103.8 points in week one. Going up against the old vet, let my Cameron go, Joe Hennessy, is projected 99.6. But you got Rodgers, Dalvin Cook, James Conner, Keenan Allen, Kelsey, MJJ, Marvin Jones Jr., the Colts defense, and Matt Prater. And let me tell you something. Don't shy away from that Colts defense. Look out for them this year. That Colts defense is special. But I'm going to take let my Cameron go in this game. I don't think Will's team has the guts. I think Christian McCaffrey's a bust. I stick to that take. I'm thinking about buying the domain name. I'm going to look on GoDaddy and see how much ChristianMcCaffrey'sABust.com costs for me to buy that domain name. And I'll post to it regularly. I'll keep you guys updated on that. Then we've got the Lake Show, Ryan Montgomery versus I Fucked Your Mom and Cam Frost. We haven't heard anything from Cam in a while. He's been pretty quiet since the draft. These are two teams who, wow, projected 97.7 to 98.8 in Cam Frost's favor. This is a 50-50 toss-up right now by the projections. Deshaun Watson, Clyde Edwards-Helaire, Cam Akers, Vontae Adams, George Kittle, Edelman's old, Brandon McManus, and the Lions. I like that Lions start, Ryan, that Lions defensive start. I like that a lot. And then Cam Frost goes Dak, Saquon, Melvin Gordon, D-Hop, Chris Godwin, Darren Waller, Marlon Mack, the Bills defense against the Jets, and Greg Zuerlein. I don't know. If I had to take my pick in this game, I'm going to have to go with the Lake Show. And here's why. You guys are going to say it's a crazy take, but here's why. Deshaun Watson will lead the Houston Texans. Almost said San Antonio Texans, but the Houston Texans to a week one victory over the Super Bowl hungover Chiefs. I would expect at least three touchdowns in the air for Watson and maybe another two run the ball. It's going to be a high scoring affair. He's going to have a lot of yards. That Chiefs defense and that Texans defense, there's going to be a lot of offense in that game, all right? But I got Montgomery winning a close matchup. Then we go to Pam was holding Jim back. Trajan Buford versus big ball brand Aaron Elkert. Projected 92.7 to 89.3. Another really close match. The odds makers in Vegas like Trey with a 51% probability. Cam Newton on his new team. The New England Patriots, how will he fare against that Miami defense that is very shaky? Maybe they come out week one and shock everybody, put up 50 points. Maybe they don't. But then on the other side, you got Josh Allen. Josh Allen, this is a big divisional matchup for Josh Allen. He's been getting cucked by the Patriots for the last 2 years that he's been in the league. He's just been getting cucked by the Patriots over and over again. Can't win the division. Is this the year that he gets over the hump and starts off against the Jets? The rest of these teams, you know, they look good. I thought Trey's team was very underrated after the draft. I really like the Josh Jacobs, Aaron Jones tandem. I love Amari Cooper. DeShaun Jackson is, he's got to be 40. So that's, you know, Austin Hooper out of Cleveland, tight end. He's got that Baker Mayfield connection all linked up for week one. We'll see how it goes. Raheem Mostert, another great potential player. Chargers defense, I think, are a very good defense, and they will continue to play well this year as they did last year. And then when you walk on over to Cam's team, we got Le'Veon Bell, James White, Michael Thomas, Julio Jones, the hits, Tyler Higbee, DJ Chark. Ravens defense is going to get blasted, anally blasted by the Browns. So that's a bad put in. And then Robbie Gould, the classic bald kicker. If I had to put my money in, I'm taking Trey Buford in this game. Fuck you, 9-inch. Then we walk on over to the last game of the week. Fire Goodell, Connor Price versus Nope Kobe, Grant McInnis. I don't know if a lot of you remember this. McInnis' first year last year, he started, I think, 2-3-0 and was putting up huge numbers. 120s, 130s numbers. It was absolutely ridiculous. Let's look at the two teams. Connie's going with Tom Brady out of the start in Tampa Bay. Is it because he's a big Tom Brady dick sucker, or is it because Tom Brady's actually going to be good in Tampa Bay? We don't know. But then you got Zeke and Eckler, good running back duo. The receivers, McLaurin could have a good year. Don't get me wrong. He could have a good year, but it's the Redskins. He's got Haskins throwing to him now. I don't trust that. But Kenny Galladay is the other receiver. Mark Andrews, a good tight end, but again, going to get shut down by the Browns. Devontae Parker's questionable. I'm done here about Devontae Parker, honestly. I think he's washed, playing for Miami still. We'll see what happens. I don't know. Seahawks defense always going to be good, especially going up against a mediocre Atlanta offense. And then you got Blankenship, Rodrigo Blankenship, the Georgia boy with the goggles coming out as the Indianapolis Colts kicker. And then you got Nope Kobe's team. Mahomes, Miles Sanders, David Johnson. You love Mahomes. Miles Sanders, I mean, he could be good, he could be terrible. We don't know. David Johnson hasn't been good since 2005, I think. But he had that one good year in 2005, so he's a good running back for Houston. Mike Evans. Now, the big news, Mike Evans is questionable this week. He's been sitting out of a couple of practices. The coaches said it's day-to-day. We're going to continue to evaluate the situation. I assume that McInnis is probably not looking at his roster, and he probably won't look at his roster. So even if Mike Evans doesn't play, I think, you know, Connie could get a free pass here not going up against Mike Evans like he did 2 years ago when there was a fucking hurricane, and I had to sit Mike Evans and kind of beat me by 5 points. Then you got T.Y. Hilton. McInnis always gets T.Y. Hilton. T.Y. Hilton's a consistent player. Then Gronkowski. So Connie's going to be throwing to Gronkowski, Tommy Brady to Gronkowski, you know, that kind of link up. It's going to be weird to see that matchup. Golden Tate starting at the flex position for McInnis. An old age vet says he's questionable. I'm not going to read that news article because I really don't care. I don't think Golden Tate's anything special, but he could be great. You know, he's on the Giants. We'll see how that goes. Patriots defense in the start for McInnis. I don't know if he's aware that the Patriots, a bunch of their defensive players have opted out. Mainly they're good players. They're going to be playing a lot of backups. The good news is for McInnis is that they're going up against the Miami Dolphins in week one, who offense is just abysmal, has always been a problem in Miami. So we will see how that pans out. I don't like the play, but then he's got Butker in at the kicker, that fucking kicker Butker. If I had to take my pick here, I'm going to go, as much as I hate to say it, with Price. Just solely off the fact of the uncertainty around McInnis' team, the Patriots defense could get negative 15 points. It's very possible. I don't see them doing much, depending on how Miami plays. But I'm going to go with Fire Goodell in that game. The projections are 94.9, 98.4 in Nope Kobe's favor, but I'm still going to go with Price in this one, just based off pure competency and relevancy in this league. That is all for our week one matchups. I want everybody to have a good week. I want everybody to wake up tomorrow, be well-rested, get all your work done, because tomorrow's a big day. Chiefs, Texans, we all have players on those teams. It's going to be a big day for everybody, the kickoff of the season, and then we ride that baby right into the weekend. You're going to be hearing more from me this weekend. I'll probably do a couple emergency press conferences, some other stuff like that, mid-games, kind of update everybody. I also want to put one other thing out there. I decided to add a rule to the rule book that if Kerryon Johnson scores more than 10 touchdowns this season, the league owes me $50 personally for all the flack that I took for the Kerryon Johnson pick. It's officially out in the rule book. Nothing you can do about it. It's executive order. That's going to be it for this episode of Commissioner's Corner. Guys, I want everybody to have a great week. I've said it. I say it again. This is a fucking good time for us. All right. Long live the league, and good luck in your week one matchups.